How's it going, guys, and welcome back to another Creativerse video. Now, I know I said some stuff about doing the graveyard in the last video, but for this time, I actually feel like branching off a little bit onto a different project. Between the last video and this, I've been doing some wall work. I built this out here and made start of the archway and laid out a template of how far out the wall's going to go. And I thought with this area here, it would be nice to make a kind of amphitheater little area, kind of like an area to give like public speeches and things like that, with a little stage. And, you know, I thought it'd just be a fun thing to do, so I thought I'd do this video. And with the river or stream, or however big I end up making it, coming down through here, I had not very much room here. And I wanted something to do with it, and I thought it would be a good idea to do something that was kind of like a public area rather than a house, because I'm going to have the wall going across there, and on the other side, I'll just run over here, because I've been doing some brainstorming about this, and I think I'll just do a little bit talking about it. Over here, I have been thinking about doing a castle on this raised area here. Just on this bit here. So the idea is the wall would be going around, kind of intersecting with this pillar here, which is just kind of a marker. And it might be a bit different, the wall, because it will be kind of like the front of the castle. And kind of have a big old castle structure that will probably take quite a long time to build. up on this structure here. So it would be kind of cool if I used this area here for kind of public works, because you know, generally, you're not going to have houses kind of like pressed right up against the front of a castle. That usually you're going to have your bigger public works there. So, you know, have the church here and then have the amphitheater here. That makes sense. At least it feels like it does. So, I've been experimenting with the shape, and this is what I think I've got working with. I'm not sure if this is going to be big enough once I actually make it. I'm going to have to do it and see. I might end up having to make it a bit bigger. But see, I'm going to have three little staircases. One there, one in the center, and one there. And the idea is like a lot of old amphitheaters, they don't actually have like seats in, like you'd have in a kind of a modern like stadium or theater of some kind. You tend to just have stone benches. So what I'm thinking is, for each layer, I'll just come out one, just like this, very simple, and just keep going like that. In this build, you know, the detail would be in the stage and the things around it. And that's the thing, like, an amphitheater is something that's quite difficult to make complicated, but I might end up, you know, I might end up fancying up a little bit with a few columns and stuff around it. You know, maybe get a slightly Roman atmosphere going on. It could be fun. Okay, so we've got that going on. This is going to be slightly awkward to build, but let's just go under here like this. This should work, actually. Yeah. And yeah, see, here's the issue. See, various bits like that are going to end up combining, and I'm not sure if that's going to look natural or kind of weird when we get to the end. So we're going to have to just do it and see how it looks. So I might end up having to alter the shape of it or redo it. But it's not a complicated shape. I'm just going to push through and get the main structure done and have a look at it first, because if it's not going to work, I want to get that done before I kind of invest in any details. And actually, because the issue is these bits here kind of combining like this, I might not have to remake the whole structure, just a bit above the combination to make it make more sense. Okay, so we've got this going on. And, you know, that doesn't look bad. It doesn't look bad. Let's keep going anyway and see how it looks. It's really cool, actually. This city is actually within, like, you know, it's still far from done, but it is kind of almost in sight now, and that would be amazing, because I've, back in Minecraft days, when I used to play a lot of single-player Minecraft, I embarked on a number of city projects, and a few of them got fairly big, but I never finished any of them. I usually played modded, and usually my world would either implode, or I'd become too excited of a new mod release. I needed a new Minecraft install for, it might be for a new major version or something, and I would eventually end up abandoning the world before the projects were completed. And so I never ended up finishing a city build. And that would be, it would be wonderful to actually finish one. It would be really, really wonderful to actually finish a city build. But yeah, it's not looking bad at all. I'll have to have a look at the corners though, because I'm not entirely sold on those yet. But let's get this coming out. I might need to make some more. Okay. But yeah, taking kind of a relaxed video this time, because I think if I try to keep the momentum going that I've had in the last couple of videos, getting loads built each time, it would eventually end up killing you. Or killing me, I should say, you know. So every now and then, I'm going to take a slightly more kind of relaxed build. Things a bit more like this, where I'm not focusing quite so much on getting, like, absolutely as much as possible built, but just on having a good time. So this is a slightly smaller project. But I think it's good to get that balance. Because if I'm always rushing, if I rush myself too much, then I will end up burning myself out again. And I don't want that to happen again. I want to find my happy medium where I can just consistently enjoy making videos. And so far, it's working. Okay, so let's see. What do we think of this? This is the question. This bit in the middle here. Whoops, I fell off. Because what I could do is I could remove these kind of like one block long pieces and have it go, have it kind of just go into a slightly more square form up at the back here, transitioning slowly into a more circular form down here. It might cause more problems though. It's difficult to tell what will be a solution and what will cause more problems here. But I am actually kind of okay with how this goes, with how this looks for seating. I am kind of okay with it myself, but I guess what I'll do is I'll ask you guys what you think, and especially if you think there's anything I should do to it to make it look more snazzy. Because I kind of like it as it is, but if there's something that you, if you've got an idea or you've done something like this before and you've got some tips, there's a lot of builders in Creativerse that are a lot better than me, and some of them watch my videos. So if any of you have ideas, of course, always good to hear them. Let's get this stuff down here. But yeah, I took a brief trip onto the Happy Town world again recently, and again, seeing just some of the amazing builds that people have done is, it's honestly mind-blowing, you know, because I spend most of my time in Creativerse. I spend in my own little world here, in my little bubble, really. So I don't see as much of other people's stuff as I should. I really should get out there more and kind of expose myself to the community more often. But when I do it, it's always amazing just seeing the level of builds that people have achieved. It's wonderful. Now let's see. I think, at least to start with, going to keep things pretty simple down the sides here and just go with a straight up wall. See, I could just, let's start simple here. Let's start simple. We can always make it more complicated in the end. And just go with a wall right the way along here too. And that will, that'll deal with at least with the majority of this big kind of drop-off here. And I might add detail to it. But for starters, I think for this area, it's just good to get the blocks down there. Build in, you know, paint with a large brush and do the finer detail later on. One thing that I have a problem with building, it's a bad habit of mine, should we say, with building, is that I don't sketch very well. I don't do broad strokes very well. I tend to get bogged down in little details when I haven't even figured out how big the thing I'm going to build is even. You know, I'm going, oh, but how's this tiny little window frame in this large build that I don't even have any idea vaguely what shape it's going to be yet, but I'm focusing on the details already. And I need to stop doing that quite so much. It would definitely help. Now, it's just, I've got a reference image I'm looking at here, so bear with me. Screen's not going to move for a second. But yeah, I'm just having a look at my reference image because I am concerned that... Yeah, I thought so. Yeah, I thought this looked weird, and there is usually a railing going down a side. You know what I could do? Just to give it something, just to make it pop, I'm gonna try a roof block motif. Yeah, I'm gonna try that. So what we'll do is we'll go down like this, just bringing this wall out a little bit. And we'll go up to the level of the stair block and then put a roof block down on the outside, just like that. And see how that looks. Now we can go over the plain one, the slope as well, but I think that a roof block might look better here because it has a bit of texture to it. And I think this is one of the situations where a little bit of texture will actually help. Yeah, see that? I like that. I'm not sure what to do with it here, whether I should, actually, no, I should probably just do that, shouldn't I? Yes, yes, okay, that works. That gives an entrance, invisible block there for some reason, into the first tier and everything. Yeah, I think that works. Okay, so I'm pretty sure I'm gonna go with that. So at this point, I should, I guess, dump a load of blocks down, fill in the back with some stone. Might have to do some resource gathering to have enough. So yeah, I'm not going rushy, but I am going to cut some basic building. So I'll just, I'll get some of the grunt work, getting the other side to emulate this, and I'll be right back to you. See you in a minute. Okay, we are getting there. We're getting there. So I'm quite happy with the sides. I think they look good. And I've started on the kind of, not the stage area yet, but the floor in front of it at least. So this, I've done a little bit of a pattern. Was going to go just checkered, but especially considering it's not just square, I ended up kind of staggering it a little bit to give it some shape. I like the result of that. And, now it's time to do the stage. The thing people actually kind of, like, I guess the podium, the bit people will stand on if they're going to give a performance or a speech or a proclamation of some kind. And what we need to be careful of is that this guy is going to be coming along here. So we've got like four blocks until the water wants to be kind of there. We can angle it away if we want to. But if we can keep it within like seven blocks, I guess that'll make it best. One possibility though is that I could have the podium be kind of like a pseudo bridge that goes over the water entirely. I've been playing with that idea, and it could work. Not entirely sure, but to start with, let's just give ourselves a bit of a frame here. Because I'm going to be doing other stuff of this. I might end up doing some stairs. I'm not entirely sure yet. We'll see. So let's just do something like this on both sides. Just give us an idea what we're playing with. And... yeah, because the idea now is I really want to get as much of this city done as possible in the next kind of like group of videos, because it's gotten to the point where I can really see it being like an actual city, and that's exciting to me. I want to have a properly done town project that I've actually come to the point of almost finishing, because most of my town projects, as I said before in the past, have just turned into like a village, like 3-4 houses and a bit of a wall, and then I end up moving on. And that is still is kind of at that stage a little bit, but it's getting to the point where it's all coming together now. Let's see. So I'm gonna have the podium. Ooh, see, the question is what blocks to use for it. One thing is I would like to have like some of these just for lights. There maybe, and just a bit higher, because the podium will be one block up. And let's see. It's a challenging one. I'm not entirely sure what to do. Let's have a look through the crafting menu. Just trying to brainstorm. Yeah, apologies. This is a bit less of an organized video than the previous one. Just you know, trying to have a more relaxing time. See, I had considered using these, but I think the rest of the build, they'll be a bit too light. These are possibly... I don't think they'll actually work too well, though. I'm actually thinking, like, these might be the best option, at least for the start. And I'm thinking, just to give it a bit of definition, I go in here. Whoops. And I give it an old upside down staircase. Just in here like that. Just to give it a little bit of shape. Okay, nice. Yeah, that's looking good. And then, say if it's like 3 blocks wide. Yeah, that works for a podium. And come out here. Ooh, that's a little bit too high. same here, I guess. Yeah, might as well go the same scheme. So let's do that. Put these guys in. For some reason, I'm feeling like the rotation mechanic is working a little bit better now than it used to, and I'm not sure if that's just me being better at it, or like it's become a little bit less likely to freak out and like spin around all over the place. But it's most likely just me getting better at it. But I'm able to control it without everything falling apart and turning to sad times now, which is always good. And what I'm actually going to do is do more of the upside down blocks here. Whoops. Just like that. And then, let's see. One full block on either side, and then upright stairs for the entrance, I think. Let's see. Yes, perfect. Okay, so I've got the 3 stairs. So the idea is we'll walk up onto the platform like this. And then we'll have this in here like that. Will we just go not checkered. Something else. So we're not checkering. I'm still going to do this. Let's see, so how many blocks we've got? Oh yeah, okay, I see. I've got an idea. Let's do this and see how this looks. Oops! I forgot how much of a drop it is. Yeah, sorry I'm being quiet there. I was just designing in my head. Let's get up to the amphitheater. Yes, that works. I like it. I'm happy. Okay, nice. I should have some lights here. Let's get some lights placed down. Again, this is one of those things where, like, most of my builds here, like this and the church, a lot of them have these little tiny details all over the place that I will gradually just add on to. And one day, when I've done loads of those, I'll spend, like, a week just doing lots of little details like that, and we'll do, like, a video just going around the whole place, looking at everything in its finished state. But yeah, I think this is a good for a little podium. So we've got this little... So, you know, if the king came out of the castle and wanted to declare something to the people, he would assemble here, and the spectators would gather around. Or it would most likely wouldn't be a king, but it would be, like, the chancellor or... councilor, or some person with an important-sounding name like that. I am the best at medieval politics. Now let's bind this with the slabs, just so it doesn't look like something that's been stuck on. I always find you can use floor details like this to make things look a lot more consistent than they otherwise would. Let's just do that as well. And, because if you've got, like, two things like this, which really are, like, part of the same thing, but you build them differently and then give them different floor styles without intertwining them in any way, it will look like you've done two different builds which just happen to be near each other. But that, now, that makes it look like really... Yeah, that works. That makes it look like part of the build. Nice. Now, the question is, how we're going to connect this to the city. Now, what I'm thinking is we'll have two entrances to the kind of area that goes onto it. We'll have one here and one over here. So, let's see. How many blocks are we playing up here? We've got... Actually, that's going to be a different length, so let's go one... two, three, and go kind of like that. Let's go three in. So, one, two, three. Then, okay, I don't have those blocks, but let's just do this then. I'm missing the right blocks for the middle, I think. Unless I'm silly and just didn't see them. Oh, I am silly. I just didn't see them. Okay, cool. So we'll have like a little side. At some point, I need to get a load more of these leaves for the hedges. I'm really running low on hedge supplies. Now let's do that. I'm probably going to have to do... the river at another time, because it's a whole... There's a lot going into this. I've got this wall to build as well. So much building, but I have ideas and the energy is high, so it's a good time to do loads of building. Now, I'm probably just going to have at least a little bit of grass going around here so I can do gardeny stuff. So I'll just come around here and do this. Yeah, but I might be running out of time, actually, because it's been a relaxed, chatty episode. I like doing these every now and then. I hope it's not too slow-paced for you. Every now and then, I do like to just do a more kind of relaxed build. I'm just going to go and make it day, though, because it's just a little bit dim. I actually have... Oh, don't take damage. I actually have a new monitor, and I'm still... kind of figuring out how to get it looking good for me. It's a little bit dark right now, but I think it's actually a contrast issue because the whites are incredibly white, and while they're not too white, I find it the shadows are a little bit too dark, and I've been messing around with the gamma, so it's not actually that. I think I might have to lower the contrast a little bit. I keep most monitors I have at 80% contrast, and this is on 80%, but I think maybe this one it is a little bit more contrast aggressive than some monitors, and I don't know much about them, so I'm still messing around with it to get things working for me. Okay, let's get a bird's eye view here. Let's go up on the temple, actually. Let's get a bird's eye view from the roof of the temple. Okay, cool. So, we've got the river coming in down here. And that's kind of... I'm going to be doing something with it in here. A little... What I'd like to have is kind of just a little garden area here. And... That's kind of it. I love doing gardens, but they are kind of difficult to do on video because I have to try out loads of different layouts. So I'll probably get some kind of a vague layout tested between now and maybe not next video, but maybe next video. It depends on what I decide I want to work on. But I probably do want to finish this off, this whole area, and get the garden done as well. Just because it would be nice to have this whole quadrant kind of done, and I want to get these walls as well finished off. Oh, actually, there's a thing I have not shown off. I left this archway undone for the longest time, but I have actually come back and finished it. So here we have the city wall archways as they're going to be. They're nothing fancy particularly, but I had it unfinished for a long time, and then I finished it. And I thought I would show you. Let's have a look upstairs. So yeah, it's nothing like incredibly fancy, but they work. And I didn't want to make them too fancy, because if you're always trying to one up your previous builds in fanciness, which is kind of, there's a temptation to do that, especially when you're making videos about them, you can end up with something like this, where all your builds are kind of trying to work together to create a larger project. It can look very silly eventually, because things start off basic and then become these massive ornate gothic cathedrals by the time you've done a small town, and that can look it can make things look out of place. So sometimes it's good to kind of throttle back on the ornate. But yeah, I think this is it for the building today. Sorry that I haven't gotten as much done as in previous videos. I felt the need for maybe just a little more of a relaxing session. But I'm pleased with the results. There is one thing I just have to go and do for the end of the video. And I'll be right back to you. Okay, guys, I'm back. So, the thing I wanted to do just before we finish up here today is, in connection with me going over to Happy Town a few nights ago, I was actually looking for the real Grum's Temple Garden, well, the Grum's Temple Garden recipe, because I'd spent quite a few hours looking for it for myself and hadn't had any luck. And, probably the majority of the player base, it's probably just, an oddly named item that was added in the new update. And, that's to be expected. But just for anyone who doesn't know, the actual story behind it is a kind of a well-known player in the community and the founder of the Happy Town kind of series of worlds. He's known by a lot of people. Called Real Grum, has been diagnosed with a terminal medical condition, and he's retreated from the Creativerse community to spend the rest of the time with his family. And it's a really, really sad thing that unfortunately is, despite all of our advances in the world, it's still a thing that is able to happen to us. It's really unfortunate that this has happened to him, and I can't really imagine what he's going through. I didn't really know him myself. I don't think we ever directly interacted, but I knew of him. Playful Corp actually introduced this item, Grum's Temple Garden, as a kind of a tribute to them, and that it's really nice that the Playful would actually get involved with the community and care about its individual members to that degree, because a lot of developers wouldn't do that. But yeah, a lot of people have been building their own little kind of memorials for him and mementos, to show their respect and sympathy for what him and his family are going through. And when I was building this temple, I actually came to the idea that I would do that with this. I didn't mention it immediately because I wanted to find the recipe, but it didn't show up. But thankfully, Saraneth was really kind and gave me a copy found in on their world. So I thought I would just take the end of this video to just to place it in here. Whoop, I turned the... Will it go in? Okay, that's what I'm going to do then. Okay. Always a little bit of tinkering with the build. What we'll do is we'll turn that on and then... Ah, there we go, like that. That's good. Interesting the way the particle has created a glow like that. That's interesting. But yeah, so I decided I would dedicate this temple to Real Grum. It's a shame we never really... spoke, and it's I'm really sorry for the way things have turned out for you, and I I'm really bad at these things. I never know what to say, but it really sucks what's happened to you, and I hope you enjoy the time you have left with your family, and if anyone's watching this video who didn't know what had happened and wants to say some words, there is a thread in the Steam forums where a lot of people are doing that. So head on over there and say something if you want to. I'm sorry for a bit of a down note at the end of the video. I felt I should I wanted to do something for him. But yeah, guys, back to the main topic, I suppose. I actually felt really good about this build. It's coming along really nice. I'm hoping it goes well with the garden. I'm thinking of whether I want to do the castle walls any differently to the main walls here. I might end up doing them a little bit differently. I'm not sure. But anyway, I'm going to do a lot of building between now and next video. Hopefully... have some more walls to show off, and then we'll probably be working on this garden here. Oh, let's have a look at what's in the chest here. A party hat. Not interested in you, party hat. I'll leave you there. I've got plenty of you in a chest somewhere. Anyway, guys, I hope you've enjoyed the video, and I'll see you next time. See you later.